Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. We're back on Eden. It feels like we haven't been on Eden for a little while now, just because of the, it was an Eden light week because of episode 666 and Wacky Wednesday, which was, again, admittedly an experiment that may have gone awry because of a mid-seed, but it was still pretty interesting. And honestly, after seeing the discussion and everything, I do think that, you know, there are definitely some better cases to be made for both sides of the Satanic Bible debate and that sort of thing. But again, that's what I love about Isaac, is that you can have these sort of debates just because there is so much diversity in the amount of different play styles and strategies you can do in the game. That's so much fun. So here's your meme of the day, artwork of the day, awesome artwork of the day, submitted by Timmy XB or Timmy. I'm pretty sure it's Timmy. Title third was Old Dookie, with a little bit of a little sissy underneath Old Dookie. And I do love the shading on this. That is, let me tell you something, as someone who is not an artist, I can confidently say that that is extremely difficult style to do, with the sketching and the pens, like the pen marks and everything like that. Really awesome stuff. Check out the full resolution version on the Invicta subreddit, and thank you very much to Tim as well. Let's hop on in to get rocking and rolling here in this here Eden run. We're gonna get her done with a 0 Delta 2 Alpha Japan America. Oh my gosh, this tears right. Well, we're starting off with that weird mop like haircut thing that Isaac calls a haircut. I'm not convinced that that's real hair. I'm sorry, Isaac. You just put on either a wig or it is like just a mop. And it also doesn't help the fact that Steam Sale is like having a tag right off of the side of your head, so it makes it look like even more of a mop or a towel or something like that. But yeah, our tears rate is not good. 2.06, 0.94 movement speed is also pretty doo-doo. I don't want to use the stars card for this floor. The reason being is because we don't save a key that way. If we do, where are you going, bro? If we do end up using the stars card here, it's going to be to avoid a hit, basically. Or if I go into the curse room to save myself half of a soul heart. Obviously, we're going to have to be very cautious with our HP because we only have 2 soul hearts to begin with. So, you know, there's a little bit of... We have to be very careful on a run like this. I am, however, I'm impressed with the amount of shot speed that we have. 1.18 is really, really, really good. And that's going to help out greatly with our shot accuracy, shot efficiency, that fun stat that I like to bring up that no one else in this game cares about. But I do, because, you know, I don't know, something to talk about, and I think it makes sense to me, question mark. Celtic Cross is going to give us a damage shield. Sometimes whenever we take damage, what that percentage is, I don't know. Sometimes it's 50%, sometimes it's 33%, sometimes it's 100%, and also sometimes it's 0%. It either works or it doesn't. Let's just put it that way. That's the easiest way to measure it. And also, we're starting off with the Razor Blade as well, which is, of course, a spacebar item that we're just not going to use anytime soon, unless we somehow get a bunch of red hearts to go along with the start. I'm going to effectively disconnect the explosions here. So, theoretically, anyway, I can shoot the top of this, and it will not... actually, we'll go over here. Do it this way. We'll just do this. This should not hit us. There we go. We are able to get the super secret room, and it's going to be famine. It's going to be blue famine, so at least blue famine will give us a soul heart when we're done with them. But obviously, having an orbital to start off with is not great. Unless if we had something like the Book of Shadows. I mean, we do technically have a little bit of invincibility with Celtic Cross, so there's a slight synergy there, but it's a synergy that I'm not a huge fan of. I would even call it an anti-synergy, only because it requires us to take hits. So, you know, it's a little counterintuitive for us, but at least if we do take damage and Celtic Cross procs, at least we will have a way of dealing, you know, retaliatory damage instead of just being able to do nothing and you know, cry about it, and that's about it. So easy peasy fight here against Blue Famine. You do have to be careful about the spread a little bit, but especially with this movement speed. But of course, with our shot speed being so high, it makes quick work of it. We could go into the curse room. I really don't want to give up the soul heart though, so I'm gonna pass. I will say that since the eye tracker episode was recorded, I've had multiple people reach out to me and say that they would be willing to donate for like the cost of like a Tobii eye tracker and that sort of thing to go along with it, to go along with the current Lightstreak goal of the keyboard tracker, so we could have like another eye tracker, except this time would also have the keyboard. And you know, I'm flattered by that kind of stuff. You know, I feel guilty because like it's not that I can't afford to do that. It's just a lot of money to spend on something that like I probably will never use again. But it is, at the same time, it's one of those things where it's like, yeah, you know, it'd be nice to have it, I guess, as an option if people want to see it more. But the way, what I was thinking of, and I've told a couple people this that have reached out and asked me to do, just they're like, hey, you know, where can I send the money or whatever? You know, I even if I had the Tobii eye tracker, I don't know if there's a way for me to make it to where I can't see the eye tracker, but you can. I thought that it would be parsed differently in OBS. But from everything that I've seen, it seems like the eye tracker will always be seen by me no matter what, unless if there's something about the technology or the software that I'm not seeing documented. So that would have to be one of those things that I would have to test out. I wouldn't be able to do anything or test it without actually having it here. But the idea of the eye tracker and the keyboard tracker was something that I wasn't even really thinking about, honestly. But it does make sense. I mean, you would just basically just be watching me play Isaac, except seeing every input and everything that I see. There's no way, to my knowledge anyway, unless if I'm streaming, there's no way for me to separate the eye tracker and be like have it like as a toggle option for people who are watching. So I can't see the eye tracker, but you can, sort of thing. Like I don't think it embeds in the videos like that. The only way that I'd be able to do something like that is if there's a way for me to hide the eye tracker from myself and then, you know, record it and then use the overlay as like an edited video or something like that. But then I'd have to sync up the audio and all that stuff. And it feels a little clunky to do it that way. So I don't know. That would have to be something that I can experiment with. But most people on the feedback of the eye tracker episode, it was positive. People were really interested. Some people were saying that it's interesting how I use my peripheral vision more so than actually looking at stuff, which is true. Like that is something that I never even really realized before, is that like I can see like that fire that I'm shooting at right now. I'm looking at the heart right now, like that half heart right here. I'm still looking at it. And I can still operate Isaac right now while being fixated on the heart. That was one of the things that was surprising to me, is that, you know, I do use my peripheral vision quite a lot. When it comes to, I shouldn't have done that, because if there's a stone chest in this curse room now, we won't be able to open it. Luckily, there's not. I am going to use the stars card here to save ourselves a key and our half soul heart in case we do get a devil deal. I mean, free lemonade is better than the razor blade right now anyway, but overall, the razor blade is a better item. We just don't have any red hearts to synergize with it, so. Yeah, I appreciate everyone offering and that sort of stuff too. I may take a couple people up on the offer. A few have just wanted to buy it outright and just send it to me. That's something that I always feel guilty about doing. It's just a lot of money to do like a one-off thing. I just feel like I don't know, man. I don't know. That's a $250, man. But I will say that if someone has any experience with it, and actually I know a few streamer friends that use it, I'll probably just end up hitting them up. If there's a way to record a video to where I can't see the eye tracker, but it shows up on OBS, and like I don't use the OBS view window for anything. Yeah. That's what sucks about free lemonade right there, is that it does not hit things in the air. I will say that if the Tobii eye tracker does have a way of doing that, then I'm definitely a lot more interested in possibly picking it up at that point. Okay, we're getting... I'm only doing this because we have Guppy's collar. Not that Guppy's collar is like super reliable, but I do want devil deals, and I do want damage here, so we're going to have to be ultra careful, but our damage and shot speed are good. Okay, so we're playing it pretty loose right now. Got to dial it back a little bit here. One wrong move, and we're having a bad Saturday. Got to make sure you get out of there as well. People have been asking me where's the analytical video as well for the eye tracker episode or stream. I'm going to be doing that as a stream on YouTube. That'll be an exclusive YouTube thing. So stay tuned for that. We might do it this weekend. Maybe not. I'm still planning on doing that because I know a lot of people are interested in it. That to help out with the Chargers out of the San Diego or Los Angeles variety. Football joke. Yeah, I'm not looking forward to this year's NFL season. It's gonna be bad. I mean, with us having Todd Bowles as our head coach for the Buccaneers, I'm not going to be paying attention at all to the Bucs. To the point where, like, I don't even know if I'm gonna watch them this season. Just because Todd Bowles is like just not good, and I don't like Baker Mayfield. So it's not gonna be a fun football season for your boy. I think the Bucs are looking at a very, very hard fall from the top. But, you know, but people are like, you know, how does it feel to not have Tom anymore? I was like, well, of course it sucks going from the literal GOAT to, to Baker Mayfield and being probably at the bottom of the division, although I'm pretty convinced that the Panthers are still going to be pretty bad. I'm not looking forward to the Saints being number one. Hey, Quint's here. Quint's are great. Really, really hoping there's going to be a Soul Heart in here. There still might be. That is a huge tiers upgrade. And the Eternal Heart also saves us. We need 15 cents. I'd love to get Dreamcatcher, too, because Dreamcatcher also gives us a half Soul Heart every single time. Every single time that we go to a new floor. For safety reasons, I have to go for the Eternal Heart first. It's really, really risky to do so, but if we get hit, then we're dead. So I pretty much have to do that. With Head of the Keeper, I'm hoping that we can generate enough money to get everything that we want in there. Because like I want Dreamcatcher for the HP. I want to get the screw, obviously, for the tiers up. We're going to need that for safety reasons too. So there's a lot of wants in there, but the Head of the Keeper does allow us to get that. And of course, Steam Sale also helps us greatly, greatly too. I mean, it reduces the amount of money needed to get all that stuff. So Death Card, we're going to use this in the big room here, just in case if it is a nasty room. And it is. Okay. Don't want to fight this without having the screw. We do have free lemonade up, though. And if I have to, I will fight in the mob trap room. I prefer not. Okay, our super secret room is here. We do get the 1 cent. We just need one more cent. Just one more cent is all we need. They're not cents. And we can afford Dreamcatcher now. I'm going to go over here and grab... This is so bad for 3 cents, but... We can't not have... The tears up from the screw here. We're fighting the boss. I really want to get Dreamcatcher. We only need 4 more cents to do so. Or sorry, we're going to need 5 cents to do so. Which is still a possibility. It's still possible. The Head of the Keeper might proc a lot. Sitting at 2.88 tiers now, we have a little bit more safety. Obviously, the biggest thing is trying to preserve this Eternal Heart. And, hopefully we get Nostats up plus HP in this one. It's going to be Bambino, so this is going to be a not fun fight. And also, he has a chance of taking all of our money that we generate with Head of the Keeper, which you know is already going to happen. Kind of, you saw me kind of double deke him there and goad him into charging us, even though we were nowhere near his charge range. I'm just trying to keep him on free lemonade, which actually did a fantastic job at giving us some extra damage there. So we are going to get at least a little. We are going to get at least a little bit of help here from the Soul Heart Department, thanks to Matchstick, or the Matchbook, I should say. Part of me kind of wants to go in the curse room, but I'm not going to. We still need to find the secret room as well, which could be north of there. Can't be here. Can't be south of there either. Can't be over here either. So it's either north of this. Yep, there it is. Okay, and this gets us Dreamcatcher. So we don't have to go fight we don't have to fight the mob trap room, even though we could use a bomb. If we really, really need bombs, which we kind of do, I am going to take the Matchstick Trinket, and that should help us out. This will get us to 2 soul hearts, as well as having a red heart on the next floor. So we played this floor very, very well. Preserving the Eternal Heart, getting Tears upgrades, and also helping future-proof this run was something that we desperately needed to do. So that was pretty clutch of us, and I'm satisfied with how we played on this floor. And I didn't see what the Dreamcatcher was because I got a message on Discord. typical Zinvicta. Quint's also going to be a big help. If you're wondering where these babies are coming from, it's from Quint's. Every time we kill an enemy up to 5, they will spawn a random baby familiar. And it is a very powerful, very useful item to have, especially if you're having, like, you know, DPS issues or whatever. Quince can really sort of fill the gap in your DPS early on anyway, especially if you get BFF or something like that. So obviously the big gets are going to be Rotten Baby, and we can go for the secret room as well as maybe get 6 cents here. But yeah, getting Rotten Baby, getting Little Brimmy, both of those are really good to get. Icicle Baby is pretty good as well, or Freezer Baby, just a Little Brimmy. And Robo Baby too. Really, there's no real bad ones to get from Quince. This is actually one of the more dangerous rooms in the game. I know it seems dumb to say that, but it can be a little bit sketchy with them floating all around. And something that I've talked about with Head of the Keeper too, and I've sort of been not a fan of the item at times, just because it seems like it makes the tiers more. It makes the tiers more heavy, which in turn affects the way that mobs in the air move, like with the not so great Isaac physics. Come on, Wrath, there you go. Got free lemonade doing some work here. Sorry I ever doubted you. We need some movement speed. We still have a long way to go to get where we want to be on this run. There we go. There we go. You see how the sort of like a cascading snowball effect of Quince, and that's one thing I love about the item is its ability to, you know, to ramp up. And oh baby, now we're cooking. Although there is a little bit of a concern here, though, because of our lack of movement speed already. Our base movement speed is really, really, really bad. But obviously with Binge Eater, we have a way to now get some stats and still gain HP and all that stuff. Binge Eater, quite frankly, one of the best items in the entire game. You're just unable to buy a soul heart here. Get Binge Eater. Binge Eater is going to give us HP. We're going to gain a stacking damage buff, which is going to decay over time, but it also gives us permanent stat ups as well. So, you know, we are going to see every time that we pick up a Binge Eater item. What Binge Eater does, it will take your item pedestals and it will turn them. It will take whatever you have on there and either flip between the original item or it's going to turn into a Binge Eater item, which is just a regular HP upgrade. But if you do take the Binge Eater item, then you gain permanent stats plus a permanent speed down, but also a stacking damage buff that decays slowly over time. So it's very, 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 very strong, especially in a run like this where we really don't have a lot going for us statistics-wise, but... Yeah, a 7-cent Binge Eater is really, really nice here. We're gonna get Soul Hearts as well. So, but again, there is a little bit of a situation here with our movement speed, because movement speed is everything in the game in terms of mobility and staying safe and that sort of thing. So it there's a big trade-off of losing a bunch of movement speed. Does the HP that you get from Binge Eater keep you safe enough damage-wise in order for you to be okay with the movement speed down? So and most of the time, the answer is yes. Binge Eater will change your run entirely. It is one of those game changer items. There we go. I dropped the free lemonade here on Mega Maw. And we do not gain a double deal, which is unfortunate. I am going to go in the curse room now. Obviously, HP is no longer going to be an issue because we're always going to get healed from Binge Eater. We're always going to have red hearts. I mean, heck, we can even go in and play the sack room if we really wanted to. Ourselves a full card here. Now, this is going to waste the Binge Eater buff, but I think playing the sacrifice room here, and on top of that, we have the option of going into the boss trap room, which will always have a Binge Eater item there, so we can heal back up immediately and continue to play the sacrifice room here. I think that this is a very good play. We are going to lose the Eternal Heart, and that's fine. We don't need the Eternal Heart here at this point. I'm going to take Monstrance because our damage is going to be pretty, it's going to be pretty high with Binge Eater. We don't need to fight the Angel Statue here. We're about to fight one anyway. And we get Guardian Angel, which I'm just going to go ahead and take Binge Eater for. And that's the nice thing about Binge Eater is that you're always going to have an item to take, no matter what. You know, and people, a great block by Monstrance there. And some people really don't like Binge Eater. They think it's a boring item. And I can definitely see why you would think that. Because it seems very one-dimensional, but once you go through the process of seeing like how much more it has to offer you other than just simply like, oh, it just gives you a ton of HP and makes you unkillable, like it's huge. Like this play that we're about to do, where we're going to go into the boss trap room and get whatever's in there. We know that it's going to be a Binge Eater item at least, because there's always going to be an item pedestal inside the boss trap room. Jesus Juice is pretty good, and we don't have to sacrifice HP for it, or a movement speed for it. So, and that's really where the premium lies with Binge Eater, is getting that movement speed back. So we're going to tap and fight Gabriel here. See here that the Binge Eater buff is now gone, but I mean, look at our stats here after all of that. You know, outside of our movement speed, you know, we're looking real solid here. Monstrous is going to deal a good amount of damage. We still have the economic advantages of us having Head of the Keeper. We're looking very, very good here now. So even though it's taken us 20 minutes to get to floor 4, hey, you know what? We're cooking. We are definitely cooking here. And even if I wanted to, I could go and get even more stats with Binge Eater, going into the shop and just picking up like the, you know, we don't need Spider Mod, we don't need the battery or anything like that. So it's there's so many levels to how good Binge Eater is on top of just making sure that, hey, stats wise, you're going to be taken care of. I believe that was Betrayal. I made a point to make sure I was paying attention this time. Don't worry. Did see the news a couple days ago, though, that the going back to the Bucks, we're bringing back the Creamsicle outfits. And Captain Fear is apparently no more. He was the He was the Buccaneers' mascot after the rebrand, and they're bringing back Bucko Bruce, which is the old pirate logo that we used to have, the creamsicle one, the guy that's got like the mustache. He kind of looks like Captain Jack Sparrow a little bit, even though he far predates Captain Jack Sparrow. Like, that's the Bucks. I don't know when the Bucks actually were teamed. I want to say like 71, 72, something like that. Shout out to Free Lemonade, man. Giving us some real opportunities here to thrive even after I said that, it's not that great. Can't tell, but Celtic Cross did proc there. That is the first instance of our damage. Yeah, you just see Quince just knocking everything down here. And of course, I do want to get the tiers upgrade. Despite us having Binge Eater, it's not a good source of tiers upgrades. So there's still some consideration. You know, it's not an automatic for every item pedestal. It's just like Void in a way. You know, Void, you don't have to use Void. By the way, here's the entire southern part of the map. You don't have to use Void in every single item room that you see. I mean, you know, you can just take the item. and sometimes there are cases where you obviously don't want to take Void. But it's just nice having the option there. You just have to be extremely cautious when walking into a chest. With Binge Eater, and much like Glitch Crown, the item will change on you pretty much instantaneously and make it to where, you know, you pick up the alternate item and you don't even get to see what the other item was. So you got to be a little bit cautious of that and aware of that. You know, you get, as an Isaac player, you get used to just walking into the item pedestal at times. Half price PH Dizzle, which would be very, very, very nice to have. Because not only can that give us tiers ups, but it can also give us movement speed upgrades from pills. So definitely want that. I don't really need the Binge Eater from restock. We're still looking to get a devil deal here because I want to get rid of all these red hearts. Red hearts, I mean, they, you know, obviously we needed them in the early going, but we don't need them anymore. At least not this many, anyway. Funny game. And we're just looking for our item room now. Which is going to be right over here. But that's the point with Binge Eater and other items like Void, too, is just that it's nice having the option there if you need it. We could take restock, but restock with Steam sales, not as good as, it's nowhere near as good as it used to be. Betrayal here. I'm just gonna take Binge Eater. I don't think Betrayal is all that great. That was incorrect. I'm thinking of. I always get Keeper Sack mixed up with Binge Eater. Binge Eater does give you tears ups. Well, as you just saw, we had a massive tears up there. So that was my bad on that. Get ourselves another of the sins. Champion form. Seeing how bad our movement speed is here, and that is just the downside of Binge Eater. Take a level 2 ball bandit. We're not going to get much. Speaking of Void, we're not going to get much out of Damocles. We're going to be honest. The reason why that is because we don't have that many more item pedestals to come across. Basically, two left. We would only have two more item pedestals that could even benefit from Damocles, and I also don't trust our safety here with Damocles. I mean, yes, we're gonna be totally fine. Like, we're not gonna lose this run unless. If Damocles falls, and that's because it's going to be due to our inability to dodge hits and whatnot and stay safe because of how bad our movement speed is because of Binge Eater. I don't think that this is the right time for Damocles. Yeah, see, we would, I would already be not liking life right now had we taken it. Yeah, there's the eraser. Do one jumper cables. Wouldn't mind getting the eraser. Well, this is a movement speed upgrade. It's not. It's a tiers up. See, we're already capped on tiers. You know, I mean, Binge Eater is just one of those. It's just the class of item that changes the run for the better, obviously, just in so many different ways. Run-defining items, and it is just that dang good. Go back and try to find our item room. And I mean, you don't have to have a limit on how many Binge Eater items you take. You know, if you just want to just ball out of control and take them all, hey, that's going to be fine. Just be aware that you're going to have movement speed problems. Like, I can't get away from this room. But at least now with Void, I don't have to take a Binge Eater item and, you know, nuke my movement speed. But still, we gain the benefits of recycling an item. I don't think we've gotten a single soul heart out of a Tinted Rock yet. We've opened like four of them. Okay, well. Looking for that old Adam room. Avoid it. The luck upgrade, and we also get a range upgrade. Another nice thing about Void here, comparatively speaking to Binge Eater, is that obviously we get to maintain any space for items that we want. And on top of that, we also get a chance to increase our movement speed. We can undo the damage of Binge Eater. And the keeper has not been paying out as much as I would have expected or wanted. That's okay. Ghost baby! Hey, there we go. Did get a movement speed upgrade. We did get a ears up as well. And we have ourselves another sack room here, which we are obviously going to be playing because there's so many hearts on the board. I'm going to take Binge Eater just to heal. I don't have to go all the way back at the super secret room. We don't need to fight Uriel or Gabriel. We'll get our soul hearts back. Right. All right. Take some rotten hearts here. Any flies that we produce are going to deal a ton of damage. Our base damage now is sitting at 9.01 with a 5.5 tiers rate. That is a very healthy amount of damage that we're doing here, DPS wise. The Infinity Stone room, by the way, in case you didn't know. If you don't know, now you know. Couple hearts here. Go destroy mom real quick. Yeah, I'd like to do, you know, going back to episode 666, I'd like to do more stuff like that, like seed comparison runs to where we say, like, We'll just get a blue baby. I mean, it's a binge eater run. There's no question that we're not going to win this one. By that, I mean, like, there's no question that, like, we aren't going to win this. Like, we're definitely going to win this. Look, you know what I mean. Anyway. But yeah, I think that would be an interesting, like, maybe not like a Wacky Wednesday series, but it would just be, it'd be cool to see how much difference the same seed can be given, like, the items that you decide to use or which, or like, which ones you don't. Whoa, that is a rainbow champion. Yeah, a rainbow champion. I could have used the fool card to get out of there, but I'm worried about it. I'm going to take fish head here as we no longer need bombs. And Jeter's going to heal us back up here. I don't think there's any reason for us to void. Now, one thing I haven't been mentioning real quickly about void Minjeter that I could have done in that room is that we don't have to void the spacebar item that shows up. We can void the binge eater item and not retain the like, you know, whatever the effect is from the actual spacebar item in there. Does that make sense? Like, we could void the binge eater item and not have to worry about void being used up for the anarchist cookbook or that sort of thing. We can just use it on the HP upgrade and then maintain a net positive of stats rather than losing movement speed, but, you know, gaining the binge eater buff or whatever. So, you know, that's just another option. It depends on just how slow you want to get, essentially. You know, and void, again, it could give you some movement speed up, just like we did in that one room. So, you know, it's we've got so many options here to play with. I think that it's a good time. I really love these type of runs where we have so many ways to win after having a somewhat of a close call with HP early on. But we really played that floor well, that third floor, and it led to us basically being where we are now, which is, you know, in a very dominant, albeit slow, position of Binge Eater and Void and Monstrance. I like my Monstrance pickup. The quick, easy way to get us a couple of quints. Didn't even know there are Globins over there. Oh, you were so slow. I'm gonna avoid it. Yeah, we got a Tears Up and Luck upgrade. Oh, man. Oh, baby. Gonna go Lusty Blood and Incubus. Yeah, that's a, apparently there are two soul hearts there. That's a big, big time damage increase for us. Eternal Heart. And we'll take the range and luck upgrade there. Another range up. Don't know if I've passed any pills. Thus having PhD, I probably have. Again, very on brand. Incubus is going to obviously just boost our damage even more here. Every stat up that we get, Incubus gets. Well, damage stat anyway. You're firing way, way, way too many shots here. Which is good. I'm saying that wasn't a complaint. That was me saying, like, for a doppelganger, it doesn't matter how many shots the doppelganger tries to shoot us. We're literally firing at double their shots. Head of the Keeper's starting to come alive now. Unfortunately, there's no more shops for us to go into unless we wanted Hush, and even then we couldn't go into Hush if we wanted to. A Sun card. We could play the Demon Judgments. Yep. We certainly could. Certainly could. If we were a min-maxing channel, that's definitely a play. You know, we could go back and play all the Demon Judgments there, heal with the Sun card, look for Binge Eater, you know, re-heal with Binge Eater item pedestals once they drop their payouts if we don't want them, et cetera, et cetera. But that would also take forever. I mean, like, that's one of those things that if we needed to do that sort of thing, I definitely would. I would do anything to win. But we just simply don't need to do any of that. That feels a little excessive for where we are. I mean, we've got plenty of advantages here. We got plenty of offensive power, plenty of defensive power, plenty of HP. We don't need to go through. Low hearts, health up, and a shot speed up. We don't actually need the health up. Good on that. And we're just looking for that air boss room. Yuck. Secret room. Kidding. Pigging out over here. If you are one of those members of the mosh pit that loves to play along with these seeds, did you take Damocles? Did you have a much different experience than I? You know, assuming that you have all the unlocks and that sort of stuff. Post them in the comments down below. Post them on Reddit. You know, people lately have been recording stuff that they've been of the runs and posting them on the subreddit as well. I love watching them. They're certainly a lot of fun to witness and experience. You know, and they remind me of like stuff that like I forgot on the floors, on, you know, particular items that dropped and whatnot. I'm gonna say, hopefully we don't do another full clear here. Obviously the two huge movement speeds up with the mark and with Lord of the Pit. It's great. We get flying now, which is going to very heavily increase our defensive capabilities and mobility, obviously, to stay safe. Now, if we had this level of movement speed and safety, then definitely I would have considered Damocles. Considered it. Not saying I would have taken it, though. Like, there's a lot of things that you have to take into account when you're talking about Damocles. The biggest one being, like, where are you in the game? Like, are you going to have any more... Are you going to have any more item pedestals that you can take advantage of Damocles with? Is it worth the risk of running it and that sort of thing? We're here and... the entire northeast, west, and east side of the map. Now that we've done all those cardinal directions, we can go down to the south side. The only other side we haven't been to. All right. Should at least check to see what's inside of the mob trap room here. Also like to stop getting hit. The deal. Almost feels like we're traveling too fast, even though our movement speed is only 1.43. I've sort of mentally acclimated to how slow we've been for this entire run. It's like we're moving at light speed now. I don't even know how to play anymore. You just look at the firepower that we've got here. Incubus and with the shot speed and tears rate. Yo. Yeah, those of you who want to cheat, here you go. You got your cheat for the cathedral. He ain't even done yet. Refuse to do this room. Hey. There you have it. Yet another room that I just flat out refuse to do. I don't care how ahead of the game we are. Look at the size of this map. That is a Vatican-sized cathedral right there. Okay, I didn't even see either one of those shots, thanks to Boiled Baby. Keep your one eye open there, Isaac. Head of the Keeper really paying out here. And I mean, money still late game is going to be useful no matter what. Even if you don't have money equals power, you never know if you get like a fortune telling machine or if you get like you know, for some odd reason need a space bar item and you find the keeper's shop. You know, that all that stuff is worth it. Oh my goodness. Oh baby. You know we're taking Friend Finder. You know we're taking Polyphemus, and you know we're taking Cricket's body. And then we can just take Vegeta. All right. Let's see if we can get an army built up with Friend Finder here. Take Binge Eater. We got 33 damage now and counting. Gotta go Tech Zero just because of Cricket's body. Why'd you have to wait to the end of the run to give us these items? It's at the very, very, very end of this. I think we just lost everyone, too. Did we get Jacob's Ladder? What the hell, man? I mean, this is when you know the game was just trolling us this entire time when we're getting all these premium items like Polyphemus and Tech Zero and Cricket's Body and Jacob's Ladder at the end of the run. Burning Claudie going insane up there. Let's go fight Megastan, why not? You can get a few more chests. Yeah, the shot speed with Polyphemus here is nuts. By God. Nope. Fake by God. Lodestone. More like no thank you stone. I mean, we're not gonna take a large. If we're gonna take a movement speed down, I'm gonna take it with a massive, massive damage up. Not just movement speed down and HP here. Not with Binge Eater. Or Maggie. All right, we slowed our roll considerably here from when we got the mark, Lord of the Pit. Infestation 2 is not bad either. I'm gonna take Infestation 2 because our individual shots are doing so much damage that Infestation 2 spiders and flies and what? Oh my god. Well. Yeah. That is lots of damage. Again, game, I don't know why you waited till the very end of the run to give us these items, but we'll take it. I think that's good enough. Let's go just smash Stanley real quick. All right, Claudies, your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to live. Oh my god, that is so much damage, bro. Uh-oh. Oh, they lived. Uh-oh. Oh, we lost our Ipecac. Oh, we have a Claudie. Super Gluttony took out all but one Claudie. Oh, we saved him. Stanley was about to do the Mega Brim. Claudie. Claudie, no. He's alive! Oh, he lived! Good job, Claudie! GG! Well, that was a pretty epic conclusion to that run there, but we do get the easy dub courtesy of Binge Eater and some pretty good play early on, I will say. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you had a great start to your weekend. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button, considering subscribing down below. If you're not already subscribed here in the Mosh Pit, I do appreciate each and every one of you that support my channel. Leave comments, all that kind of good stuff. And thank you very much for being here and watching this video. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Like, thanks to patrons of mine like Akira Bay, Ashlyn West, Shock Top, Nathan Tolofsen, Nikolai Nenchev, and Dylan Beard. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.